We're out here doing a little fall planting. It's November the 5th in Southwest Missouri. We talked to Ian at Chestnut Hill Nurseries. He shipped us up some of the Dunstan Chestnuts. He assured us it was not too late to plant. These trees are about to go into dormancy for the winter. So as long as we get them in the ground now, let those roots start to get established. Once they go dormant, they'll be just fine and come back hard in the spring. Fall is actually a great time to plant. Most people think of spring when they think of planting, but planting food plot trees in the fall has a lot of benefits. It's a lot cooler, it's a lot nicer to get the work done. Let those trees establish roots over the winter during their dormancy, and then you're ready to rock come spring. So we're gonna get these Dunstan Chestnuts in the ground. You see I've got one already planted behind me. You wanna plant them about 30 feet apart. You don't want them any closer than that, and you have to plant trees at least two at a time for germination. So we're gonna plant a line of them right down this old fence row. I need to do a little bit more clearing, but I figure we'll get these in the ground, let them go dormant for winter, and then in the winter I'll work on clearing and give these trees a little bit more space, keep the weed bed down so they're not competing with the tree. When you dig your hole, what you want is a hole that's about twice as wide, but no deeper than the root ball on our tree. So you see we've got our tree right here. This is how they'll come. So you'll want a hole to be that deep, but about twice as wide, because those roots are gonna grow out instead of down, all right? So we're just about finished with our hole here. And then the next step is to take the tree out of the pot. So you wanna go ahead and make sure you squeeze it a little bit, get that all loosened up because you don't want that to loose, and they'll slide right out of the pot, no problem, okay? Toss that to the side. Now this step is very important. You wanna take these and sort of rough up and get those roots loose. See how those roots are coming out? All the way around that plant, get those roots nice and loose, give them as good of a head start as we can give them. So then it's just as easy as you're planting anything else in your garden. Make sure, I've got a little too much dirt out of this hole, so I'm gonna put a little more back in, get your rocks out of there. That's about right. All right, get your tree in there, and then just bring your dirt in around it, making sure you're getting that sucker planted in there. Now a lot of times, if you've got the ability, I didn't have the ability to do this, if you've got the ability to run a tiller down through where you're gonna plant trees, you'll get all this root, you'll get all this weeds and grass up, the grass mat up, and basically you're gonna start that tree off with no competition. I'm gonna have to come back and do that later. My goal right now is just to get these trees in the ground. Leave your tree bed a little lower than the surrounding ground. Just aids for more water to be able to stay in there instead of just running off. Helps that tree. Any little bit of help you can give that tree. The next step, you want to water your tree in. So if you're close enough that you can do this with a garden hose, that's definitely going to be the easiest. You would take that garden hose and just really make sure that that water is getting in. You want to make sure there's no air pockets. Make sure that you kind of get that water in. We're out here in the back 40. We can't get a hose out here. So what I've got is some water in a tank. And I'll very simply, I'll pour some in. Just really kind of get that water, make sure that water works down there. Get rid of all the air pockets. Now, a step that we're missing that you might want to do, but I'm not gonna do it because I haven't already worked the soil. But if you've tilled this and you've worked the soil, something that you might wanna do is put a weed mat down here, because then that'll keep any more weeds from growing up. I'm not gonna do that here because I haven't gotten rid of my weeds yet. So you can take a grass mat, just cut a stall, work it right over to the base of the tree, get it down and just stake it on four sides. Now you've given that tree another advantage. So whether or not you use the grass mat, the step after that would be the grow tube. This is basically like a mini greenhouse. It's gonna help protect that tree from the elements. It's gonna collect light. You can see it's translucent, it's not black. It's also gonna collect water. Extra water is gonna go down this tube when it's raining or whatever. And it's gonna act as sort of a cage so your deer aren't eating your trees, which is definitely gonna happen here in Southwest Missouri. But here in 3 years, hopefully, when it starts bearing fruit, that's when I want the deer to eat the trees. So we're gonna just take this very gently. Don't worry if you knock off some leaves. These leaves are gonna all fall off when this tree goes dormant anyway. You take your stake, stick it down in. You can see this already has the holes in it. So what that's made for is a zip tie or these that, you know, these will come with the grow tubes, but if for some reason you lose them, you can use wire, zip tie, and use any sort of stake, and that's that. Last step with these grow tubes, they'll come with this. This is to protect it from birds and different things from crawling down in here, okay? Just kind of give it a little added protection right there, all right? That's your last step. You got your trees planted. We're gonna keep on going right down this line while you go do what you're gonna do, and hopefully we finish by dark, but get our fall planting done, so hopefully within a couple of years, these trees are gonna bear nuts and we're gonna kill big deer.